Hi everyone, namaste. This is Mekhla from Pujas.in. In this video, I would like to talk to you about Akasmika Dhanalabha or sudden gain of wealth. Now, all of us want wealth and we want it all of a sudden. See, we have a fixed job or a set business and we can probably predict that, you know, this is how much I can earn. But in spite of that, what we do is like, okay, no, we have aspirations, we have desires, and we say, no, I really want to earn more. I wish I can get a bonus in my salary. You're waiting for the Diwali bonus or the New Year bonus, or sometimes the Ayudh Puja bonus, some companies give that. And sometimes we are also waiting for a good offer so that we can jump over to another job. Sometimes we really hope that, you know, we have a secondary source of income where we suddenly earn a lot of money. So we all have hopes. What if I could? What if I could? You know, those many, many what if I coulds we have in our life. But nothing really materializes because there's nothing. So there's no yoga in our chart which says that you can probably encash on this particular period of time for a sudden wealth growth or sudden wealth windfall. So what are these yogas? And you know, just because you have a yoga in your chart, does that really mean that you will end up earning lots of money? If that is the case, you know, from birth you should have been born with a golden spoon, right? Some are not, but still they have yogas. So what is it that you can look for in your chart which gives you that hope or an aspiration that yes, you are eligible for a windfall, that you can expect something good to happen in the near future? So it is basically the yogas, we say. So yogas are basically a combination of planets in certain houses through positioning, through aspecting, like they look at each other and, you know, so they create some yogas which can be favorable. Some yogas are not favorable also. And we are not today here to talk about the non-favorable ones, but we are here to talk about the favorable yogas. So which can really boost your finances. So they are the ones who can give Akasmika Dhanalabha. And apart from yogas, there are also certain planetary positions of Shukra, that is Venus, and Buddha, Mercury. And in combination with Guru, which can really give you that windfall. And Rahu is also known for, you know, sudden growth and sudden downfall. So Rahu's positioning amplifies the yogas also sometimes. So we'll have to look at your chart to know exactly, I mean, why you're not yet experiencing good results despite of having a yoga. And if at all you have a yoga, when is it that you can see that the yoga will get activated and fructify? So one is the positioning of planets and then aspecting, I told you. But this is not good enough. You need to, you know, the yogas usually get activated during the dashas of those planets. Like for example, you have a Lakshmi Narayan yoga, or, you know, or any Raja Yoga, which planetary combinations which create the Raja Yoga. So then during the dasha of those planets which are creating the Raja Yoga, you will see that the Raja Yoga gets activated, and that is the time you can expect very good results. And not just that, assuming that the gochara, the transits of planets are also favorable, then you can mint money. But assuming that you know, you don't have the transit, favorable transit, then the effect of the yogas are also not effective. Sometimes even if you're going through a very bad yoga, you will see very good results only because the transits are favorable, which is why I always insist on the transit pujas to make sure that 1 year, 1.5 years, or for Shani say 2.5 years, are always like going to be very peaceful, and you know, you can make the most of it because that is tatkala, like, you know, at this point of time, what can you expect? The present, how is it going to be? That is what is going to decide. So these yogas are very, very important. So like, you know, I also have a Buddha Aditya yoga in my chart, but not that, you know, from childhood I had a great time or my finances were great or nothing like that. Certain times are there where these things get activated. And it's not wrong to know if you have a Raja Yoga in your chart, or if you have any yogas or if favorable transits coming up, or even for that matter, like, are you eligible for a windfall or Akasmika Dhanalabha, like sudden gain of wealth? Because we have a lot of pressure either from the family or from our own aspirations. Like, I remember I would really, like, you know, pressurize my dad as a child, you know, being immature, you know, to buy me things, and he would have to forcefully, you know, swipe his credit card because he couldn't really meet the requirements that were demanded. So those are not like great demands or anything, but they are pressure, especially if your income is not proportionate to what you ask. So I understand that nowadays the peer pressure is so much so much peer pressure from everybody, like, you know, you have to make sure your children go to the best school, and if their parents are giving them an international holiday, you need to do that. It's not that you need to do that, but they compel you to do that. So these kind of pressures are there. We all go through these pressures, and you know, sudden windfall is our only hope to get that extra income to make sure we meet all the expenses and you know, are still comfortable without getting into the borrowing mode. So in this video, the main idea is to tell you that all of us may be having some yogas, and there are times which can indicate that, okay, this is when the yoga can get activated. So in case you want to know from your chart, okay, what yogas you have and when they are likely to get activated, do reach out to me. I'll be very happy to help. Thank you so much.